It's amazing the things you think of when you're gone for good. All the little things, the things that went wrong, the things that went right. What if you could just come back?
I never used to have trouble with that.
Well, it's late. You're tired.
I'm not tired.
Okay, you're not tired, but it is late, and Joe needs to get some sleep.
Was I too loud?
We talked about this, and you made me a promise.
I just have to know that I can play this song. It was your mother's favorite. Lorraine always...
You play it fine.
But I'm having trouble with one part, and I never used to.
Tomorrow, okay? You can play it for me tomorrow.
Shouldn't you be in bed?
What time is it?
It's late.
How'd it go? We found copies of the missing contracts, so their case is out the window. Come on, let's celebrate.
Oh, I can't. I've got work to do.
Well, that's why God made tomorrow.
I know, but there's a deadline. It has to be done tonight.
If this job is too much for you,
my
just tell
job
me.
Is not too much.
Fine. Okay. You coming to bed?
Not until I get this work finished. You were gonna leave this morning without saying goodbye.
You were asleep, but I didn't want to wake you.
Any idea how long you'll be?
Yeah, it depends what they have for me on the other end.
She'll be home by Christmas, won't you? Joe? No, this is about my father. I talked to him this morning and he promised.
Buddy's not the problem. This is also.
Tell me what it is. I can handle it.
I can't do this anymore. You know, I wanted to bring this up 1,000 times.
Oh, but you thought now was perfect. 3 days before Christmas.
You knew this when we started. That it was just gonna be casual. No strings. And when it wasn't working for either one of us. I'll call you later, okay? And we'll talk about it.
Okay, yeah. That'd be great.
Don't let Buddy drive you crazy.
It's my father. That's his job.
How's it going? Need some help?
No, I got it covered.
I still don't understand how a person can make a living off these.
You can make a living selling just about anything over the internet. Oh, Pop, those are still wet.
You know, your mom used to collect those. Stuck them everywhere they'd stick all around the house. Whatever happened to all those, I wonder?
I have them.
How long is he going to be gone this time?
Quite a while.
You two ever think about getting married?
Pop, I gotta get to the post office.
I can't imagine your mother and I living together without a marriage license.
If I leave you here alone, do you promise not to smoke?
How can I smoke? You won't let me. 11 months.
You and I both know you do it every time I go out.
I don't.
I found the carton you stashed behind the piano. I took it. Just trying to keep you alive.
Well, and what's the point in me staying here alone? Maybe I will tag along.
Fine. You want to come along? Come along. You're gonna have to carry the box.
But you didn't tell me I was gonna have to work.
It's not good enough. It doesn't sell the product.
You could be more specific.
I don't buy it. If we're going to lure this client away, we need to find a fresh approach they'd never think of.
Preview it?
It's old-fashioned.
And what does a woman with a 40-inch bust have to do with cat food?
It's her cat.
You need to rethink the presentation.
Howie was just looking for you about the 11 o'clock. The client wanted it moved up.
Up to when?
Now, in your office.
It's gonna be one of those days, isn't it?
Just right here.
Oh, no. It'll
take 3 days to get done.
You all right? Well, what time are you going to take your break?
The same.
Here. That's it.
We're kicking around a campaign that will take advantage of the reality television look. You know, handheld, unpolished.
If we could hurry this up, I have a lunch waiting.
Right. Beth, why don't you fill in some of the details?
Our research suggests that your chunky pasta sauce sells only marginally better than your other varieties, yet costs a third more to produce. What we're suggesting is that we focus the new campaign on the chunky. Give it more visibility in the marketplace.
Uh-huh.
You like that?
Good.
Yeah.
Good. How do you plan on doing that?
Sorry for the interruption, Beth, but there's a call for you.
Can you take a message, please?
It's your sister. She says it's an emergency.
If you'll excuse me, I'll be right back.
She'll be right back.
Howie. I got a lunch.
He had a stroke. At least, I don't know. I think it was a stroke. He was fine one minute. The next, he was on the floor. The paramedics were taking him to St. Joe's.
Very casual sort of business indeed.
Should I fly out? How important is it?
Is it important? No, Beth. He's only our father. Sorry if this call comes at an inconvenient time for you.
I only meant that it's almost Christmas, and it's not that easy to get away.
You know, it just... Never mind. I don't know why I bothered.
Hello? Sarah. Great. Paula?
Yes, ma'am?
Did you put this photograph on my desk?
What photograph? Dr. Fine,
I brought your crossword book. You finished most of them, so I'll pick up another one from downstairs.
What'd they tell you?
That you haven't been taking care of yourself.
What'd they tell you it was?
Possibly a mild stroke. But nobody knows anything yet, so you just rest and let them do what they do, okay?
Did you call Lorraine? Does she know?
Pop, Mom died years ago.
I met Beth. Did you call Beth?
Yes. She's flying out.
Then it's bad.
No, it's not bad. It's not bad, it's not good, it's not anything until we get the test back.
I wish you two got along better.
And I wish you would relax and stop talking. It can't be good for you. I got you some gum and candies, but you need to talk to the doctor first and make sure it's okay.
I'm scared.
I know you are, Pop.
The flight was a nightmare. Two stops on the way, no food, some security thing. Thank God the woman sitting next to me had a protein bar, or I probably wouldn't have made it.
Pop's doing much better. I'm sure you were just about to ask.
Thank God.
He's under observation at the hospital.
So what was it anyway?
Well, we'll know when we know.
This isn't a security facility. Your father apparently dressed himself and walked out.
And no one stopped him?
If he's still in the building, one of our staff will surely find him.
still think we should call the police.
Don't worry. Sometimes he takes a cab out here when he's worried or needs to be alone.
It reminds him of home.
How do you know?
Because I know Dad.
I don't know. Is there time? How would I get there? Drive. I don't drive anymore. Not that I couldn't, but...
Pop, you left the hospital. You're supposed to wait there for your tests.
I'm waiting here.
Hey, Dad.
Beth. Oh, Beth.
It's so good to see you. I hope you didn't come all the way from Chicago for this.
No, not for this. For you.
Still beautiful. Prettier every time I see you. Isn't she beautiful, Sarah?
We really need to get back to the hospital.
It's Christmas in a few days. I want to go home.
Fine. We'll go by the hospital, we'll go back to the apartment, and you can play the piano for us late as you want, okay?
Not the apartment. Trinity, where you grew up.
But that's so far away.
Lorraine wants me to come home for Christmas. She wants you girls to take me there.
Pop? I wish that were true. I wish more than anything that Mom were waiting there for us, but the fact is... nobody's lived there for years.
I'll walk if I have to. I mean it.
Dad, you're not feeling well.
What could you possibly expect to find there after all these years?
Home. Home.
Grocery store. I wonder if old man Tompkins still runs it.
He died. His wife runs it now.
How do you know?
The weeks that I spent here after the funeral. Closing up the house, dealing with all the red tape.
I had just joined the company. I couldn't take all that time off.
If you hang a left up here, Sarah.
Dad, I know where the house is. Well, Pops, this what you were looking for?
Hasn't anyone been taking care of this place?
Pops can't handle this alone, and I can't manage this and my place in L.A.
Well, why don't you move back here?
Why don't you?
Who's got a key?
Same place it's always been.
Milk can.
Freezing in here.
The fire will take the edge off till we get the furnace going.
There used to be a picture hanging there. The four of us in a frame with cherubs on the corner.
It's probably in storage. I put away what I could and left the rest. There's a lot of stuff in the basement.
Well, we can't stay here tonight, that's for sure.
Of course we can. It won't take us long to put us back in shape. A little elbow grease, some spit and polish, good as new. What do you say?
Spit and polish?
I'll spit if you polish.
Oh,
I'm sorry I neglected the place. I let you down, Lorena.
I'm leaving the bathrooms for you. I can't.
It's fine. I'll get to it.
I just saw Dad out there in the snow. That can't be good for him.
He likes it. Says he keeps better when the temperature drops.
What'd the doctor say? When he pulled you aside before we left the hospital?
He said, coming home was probably a good idea. It might be his last Christmas. Idea, you should go with it.
I know how to spit. Want to see?
No, thanks. I think I'm on a bet.
Oh, come on.
Hey, I'll help you with that.
Hey, Mr. Clock. I didn't do it.
Yeah, sure, Frankie. We know you didn't do it.
Alex? Sarah?
Oh, Beth's sister.
Yeah.
What are you doing back in town?
Oh, my. Dad missed the old place, wanted to come back for the holidays, so we brought him home. Beth and me, she's in from Chicago.
Sorry to hear about your mom. She's a great lady.
Thank you.
You've changed. Grown up, I mean, in the nicest way.
Oh, just taking it one day at a time.
Yeah, I feel you.
I'm glad I caught you. You almost forgot this.
Thank you, Mrs. Tompkins. It's about the extent of our decorations this year.
It's gonna be a tree?
No decent tree is gonna fit in the car. It's gonna have to do.
Well, I'm glad you're back. So you tell Buddy I said hello, okay?
I will.
It's really nice the way that Sarah's blossomed.
So, Pop's probably waiting for me.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Good to see you again.
Yeah, you too. Okay.
I know how to spit real far. Want to see?
Maybe later.
Are those for tonight? I would have helped.
Oh, it took a minute. We couldn't use them the way they were.
Did you get any cupcakes or anything? I'm craving something sweet.
Since when do you have a sweet tooth? There's some ice cream. You might put it in the freezer. Where did you get these?
Get what?
The magnets. I thought I brought them all back to the city. These weren't here when I got back from the store.
I don't know, maybe Dad found a couple.
Nellie! What are your sight for sore eyes?
Hi, buddy. I know it's your first dinner home in a long time, so I thought you'd appreciate this. It's Lorraine's meatloaf. She gave me the recipe years ago, and I thought he'd bring back some nice memories.
Well, that's very thoughtful of you.
Hello, Sarah.
Hi.
Beth.
Hi.
I hope I'm not intruding?
Not at all.
Oh, no. Come on in and stay a while.
I'm sure you have a lot to catch up on. I just enjoy. And it's just great to have you back home again.
Whew, meatloaf. Who's hungry? Me!
I've got news. This is not your mother's meatloaf.
Yeah, Nellie said she made it from Mom's recipe.
Well, it sure doesn't taste like it. Could I have the pepper, please? Thank you. Maybe a little ketchup, too. Thank you.
The potatoes are good.
The potatoes are good.
Dinner didn't sit well. It'll pass.
Hey, Beth, if I was short with you earlier, I'm sorry. It's not you. It's not entirely you.
Of course it's me. It's me, it's you. We never got along as kids. Why should today be any different?
I'm sort of hoping we had outgrown that by now.
The watch Mom and Dad gave me when I turned 16. The one you stepped on and broke.
That was an accident.
Please. You were so jealous.
Well, what was it doing on the floor in the first place?
Wait,
you never appreciated.
Stop. It's this house. It's like we never left. Listen, if Dad's feeling better, I really should be getting back.
You've been here what? A day?
Well, I'm here, okay? With a disappointed husband 1,500 miles away and $1 million account hanging by a thread.
He is our father, Beth, not some account that you can handle. And I've been picking up the slack by myself for years now, and I'm tired. You need to learn to give a little. You are part of this family too, remember.
I talk to you more now that you're gone than I did while you were alive. We're lost, Dad and Beth and me. Just, we don't see eye to eye. And I see now that it was you that held us all together. But I just can't seem to do it. And if there was just enough magic left in the world to grant me one wish, I wish that you were here.
Did you make the beds?
Did I make the beds?
No.
What are you talking about?
Nothing, just make your calls. I'll take care of everything, as usual.
See, she still hates me.
I miss times like these. Just the two of us bringing in the day.
Who are you talking to just now?
Your mother and I used to love this private time in the morning.
Yeah, I remember. Beth and I used to listen to the two of you laughing in here. Well, you've been very busy this morning. When did you learn how to bake a pie?
Well, that's your mother's.
Well, you've been going through her old recipes?
I was telling her just last night. It's been years since we've had one of her pies.
You were telling that to Mom.
Beth, we've got company.
Hey.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good.
It's a beautiful day.
Alex! Oh, my God. Alex,
hey.
How did you know we were up here?
Your sister didn't tell you that she ran into me.
Not a word.
Sorry, must have slipped my mind.
It's been a few years.
They hid me away in Los Angeles. It's good to be back, I'll tell you that.
You look great. What have you been up to?
I took over the family business. Long hours, hard work, and I love it. It was a surprise to see Sarah. I wouldn't have recognized you if you hadn't introduced yourself. Oh, back at school.
High school was a rough time for me.
Needed room to spread your wings, I guess.
I guess.
Heard you were in the market for a tree.
You got us a tree?
Last one on the lot. Looked like it needed a home.
Lorraine was just saying the house wasn't the same without one.
Just need someone to tell me where to put this.
Beautiful.
You have ornaments?
I think they're in the basement.
And the angel for the top, Lorraine's angel.
It's somewhere, Pop. We'll find it. Thank you so much, Alex. This was very sweet.
I'll leave you to it then. Just wanted to wish you Merry Christmas.
I'll walk you out.
All right. How do you like Chicago?
It's amazing. I've got a great job at an ad agency.
And you're married. That's some lucky guy.
He's a good one.
I bet. What about Sarah? She's single? She didn't mention if she's...
She's living with someone.
Oh, yeah, right, of course. Good for her.
Do you ever miss those days in high school? Homecoming, king and queen. We had a lot of fun.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah. It's a shame we all had to grow up.
Look at you. It all worked out. Great life. Great job. I'm happy for you.
Thanks.
Have a good holiday, okay?
Yeah. You too.
I see you out there.
Did you and Alex have a nice reunion?
He certainly has improved, don't you think?
Really? I didn't notice.
Sure you didn't. How did we not notice how pitiful these were when we were kids? Did we have no taste at all back then?
Like Mom used to say. Ornaments don't shine until they're on the tree.
I'll believe it when I see it.
I don't know what I did with Mom's angel.
Maybe you took it back to L.A.
Did you know that Pop baked an apple pie this morning?
Really? He used to burn cornflakes.
And he made our beds.
Nice. He's getting his energy back.
Beth, Pop has never baked anything or made a bed in his life.
People his age go through all kinds of weird phases. Sarah, come here.
What?
So that's why he wanted to come back. He has a girlfriend here.
Mrs. Tompkins.
I thought there was a spark between them when she brought the meatloaf over.
So this has all been a scam to get us to drive him to a date.
That old rascal.
I'm putting my career on the line so he can play footsie with Mrs. Tompkins.
Oh, they're just holding hands.
What should we do?
Well, the first thing we're gonna do is decorate the tree. Grab something.
There's gotta be more ornaments.
And what about the lights?
None of them work. It's a wonder they lasted our entire childhood.
It's a wonder we lasted our entire childhood.
Did you do that?
Set doilies on the furniture?
No, I thought that you did it.
And look at that. The drapes have been hung up. Looks like Nellie Tompkins making herself right at home, one chore at a time.
Oh, good. Take some of the pressure off of us. But how does she do all this without us knowing about it?
Weird.
I'm in the mood for cocoa. Who's with me? That tree needs more ornaments. And haven't you girls found Lorraine's angel for the top yet? There's more of this in the kitchen if you want some.
How did you make that so fast?
It was waiting for me on the counter. See for yourself. Me, I'm gonna take a hot bath.
To leave it for us after school. I didn't buy any marshmallows.
I need a cigarette.
I can't help you out there. The only thing I'm addicted to these days is chocolate.
It's okay, I quit anyway.
That's probably smart. Assuming we share any of the same genes, I'd hate to see you go through what I did.
Oh, poor Sarah. She had it so rough.
You had everything handed to you. Isn't Beth pretty? Isn't she smart? Isn't she just perfect? It's no wonder I'm so screwed up.
Are you making this my fault now?
No. I'm just telling you the way that it was.
Yeah. Mom and Dad weren't very good at raising children, were they? You think it's genetic?
Luckily, I'm not very likely to find that out.
Well, you could have said something sooner. The girls have been looking all day. There's my pretty. This is what was missing. Now everything's exactly the way it was.
Finally remember the whole thing.
What are you doing?
Leaving. Dad's fine. You really don't need me here.
He's not gonna kill you to spend some time with Pop.
I've done all I can. I'll call when I get home.
Christmas to you too, little sister.
Morning, Beth.
I thought all this stuff was put away. You found the angel.
Right where she said it was.
And see the lights?
You fixed the lights?
No need to fix what isn't broken. Pretty, aren't they?
It's just a loose bulb. Mom? You're home for Christmas. No. I'm dreaming. This is not possible. It's just not.
Impossible things happen every day.
Do you remember that? That's a song.
From Cinderella. You saw it when you were about six, and you sang it over and over again. Drove your sister crazy.
She took my doll.
And wouldn't give it back until you promised to stop.
But how would you know that? Unless... So then it really is... You? I miss you so much. You need to come out here.
You'd be halfway to the airport.
Seriously.
Stop, okay? Tell me what's going on.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I can't tell you because I need you to tell me. Come on. Good, you see her too. Mom?
I told you Lorraine wanted us here this year, and you know your mother when she gets an idea in her head.
But she's... You stay away from me, I mean it. Who are you?
I haven't changed that much, have I?
Beautiful as ever.
Who is this person? Well, it seems to be Mom. That's crazy. She's...
Merry Christmas, honey.
No, I mean it. You stay away from me. I don't know who you are or why you're doing this.
Sarah. She really is your mother. Sarah, Beth.
That is not her mother. What are those? Those are Mom's cinnamon rolls. And the coffee? Smell the vanilla? Okay, I'm obviously having some sort of weird flashback or withdrawal thing, but you, are you insane? I mean, you don't actually believe this, right? Well, I didn't at first. But now, I think it's really her. Maybe it's her Christmas gift to us.
I should have done more to prepare them. You know, the magnets on the refrigerator, the pies, the marshmallows. What was I thinking? I should have done more.
I know. We need to dance. Let's put on some music.
Well, the record player's in the basement.
Then who needs music? and give Sarah time. She'll come around. You know, we haven't danced like this forever.
Mm-mm.
Used to do it every Saturday night.
Oh, we won that trophy at the lunch.
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
Best waltz.
Uh-huh.
Nobody waltzes anymore.
Oh.
That's why.
Listen to them. Remember how in love they were.
Beth, we have to focus here. I mean, there must be some other explanation, something that we're not considering.
I didn't know the phone was turned on.
Neither did I. Answer it.
Hello?
Hey, it's Joe.
Merry Christmas. I called the apartment. Your
phone must have said you'd be there. What's going on?
This is not really a good time right now.
Well, don't hang up. Look, I'm sure you're mad. You're hurt.
No.
I get that.
No, it's not that. It's just, well, Pop got sick and things have gotten a little bit weird. And, well, Beth is here and we sort of have some company. It's very hard to explain.
Look, I don't want to leave things the way that we left them.
I really have to go. Thank you so much for calling and Merry Christmas and all that, but later, Kayla.
Sarah?
Your mother wants to see us. Family meeting.
Pop?
Yes?
You don't find this a little bit strange?
I find it wonderful.
She died, Pop. Years ago, and I mean, whatever is happening here is not...
Don't question it. Please. Just don't.
And why should I believe that you?
Well, because you asked me to come. In L.A., remember? Out there in the park?
And what you said the other night on the porch, night before last, you were so right, Sarah. I left so many things unfinished. So you need me. And here I am.
You heard that?
Oh, yeah.
You came because of Sarah?
Look, all I know is I've been given a chance to fix things and leave the family better off than when I left before.
So are you here for good?
I'm here for Christmas.
And then what?
Sarah, can I just hug you, honey? It's been so long.
I'm sorry. I think I just need to sit with this a while.
Okay. Well, I did the best I could with the tree. Half the ornaments are missing.
Yeah, I thought they were in the basement.
Well, we'll have to dig them out. They're a family tradition. We gotta get back to basics. What a mess.
It's your life.
Oof, my point exactly.
Your jewelry and souvenirs and papers I put in this box. Your clothes I gave to charity.
Oh, my.
Oh, you know what? Not that. What's that?
My obituary. Lorraine Bryce, loving wife and mother.
Mom, please don't.
Can I see it?
Mm-hmm. Who wrote this? I did.
Born in Wyoming in 1946.
That should be
1947.
Oh, that's a typo. Do you want them to print a retraction?
I don't think it matters now. It's so short.
I didn't know what to say.
I would have written in if you'd asked.
I did.
Thank you for writing it, Sarah. Seeing your life reduced to that one paragraph, it really makes you wonder.
There was just so much going on at the time. And yet you were always the favorite.
Your father and I didn't play favorites.
Isn't it against some universal law for you to lie right now?
I did everything but stand on my head to get attention. I had to fight for everything that I got.
So did I. You don't start. Anytime you had a problem, you ran to Mom or Pop or the boyfriend of the week and they took care of it. Did you ever in your life have a problem that someone didn't handle for you? Girls, and did you ever think that maybe you're the lucky one? Are you saying that it was a good thing that my childhood was crap? That it took years of 12-step programs and more failed relationships than I care to remember to pull my life back together? Besides, what is the worst problem that you have to deal with right now?
I'm pregnant. And I don't want to be.
Oh my God. Does David know?
No, he doesn't.
You've been watching us?
I keep in touch.
Why haven't you told him?
Because I haven't decided what I'm gonna do about it yet.
Can we not talk about this anymore?
You know, this isn't good. I obviously can't do anything about the lives you've had before, but I can help with the lives ahead, if you let me. That's the question, if you will let me. So could we just have this one holiday?
I'd almost forgotten what winter was like up here in the mountains.
I hate Los Angeles. Flowers blooming in December. It's just not right. And all that traffic. At any time, people in a hurry to get someplace other people are hurrying just as fast to get away from. It's crazy.
Sarah is doing her best by you. And you don't help. No, you really don't.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a dream.
You manipulator. Pretending to be sicker than you are. Forgetting things. Except for that heart of yours. You're as sharp as ever, and you know it.
This is why I miss you. Nobody ever knew me like you.
Our family's kind of fallen apart since I've been gone. Maybe it happened before and I just never noticed. But either way, I have to set it right.
Just being here makes it right. Just having you home.
What's this?
It's your meatloaf. Mrs. Tompkins made it from your recipe. She said it didn't taste anything like yours.
No one could ever make that like you do.
It was definitely missing something.
Yeah.
Did you give her the whole recipe?
I don't remember. Okay, maybe I didn't write down all the ingredients so that Nellie couldn't copy it exactly. Oh, I'm so not proud of this. I never said it was perfect.
Right. What are you doing?
Making things right.
So you came back to fix a meatloaf recipe?
Well, it is one of the loose ends, yes. And there's so many. Do something for me, will you? There's this library book.
Library book?
It's one of those awful romance novels. I was embarrassed, I guess. I wanted you to think I had better taste than I did. Here we go. The point is, it has to go back.
Now?
Well, you come to see, there's no time like the present.
But right now, it's Christmas. The library's closed.
And... well, I can't do it. And you can't imagine how much this weighs on a person after they're gone. It's important, Sarah. And there's a book drop, you know.
Okay.
Library book.
Why in the world?
One day, I hear David's voice, and I know that I can't live without him. And the next, I look across the room, and I wonder who he is. Who is this person that I'm married to?
That is just the nature of marriage, darling. It was like that for me and your dad. And then once you introduce children, it gets even stickier. But David is going to be a wonderful father.
But it's not about that. I don't know that David and I are ready to be parents.
I don't know anyone who's ready to be a parent. If everyone waited till they were ready, no one would have children.
Mom, listen to yourself. Do you see what you're doing?
Well, I see an answer to your problem, and I want to fix it. That's my job.
Not anymore. That's what you always did. You're making me feel like I'm 10 years old again. But I'm not. I'm an adult now, and I need to fix my own problems. Okay?
There you are. Can I get something for you?
Hey, what are you doing here? You should be home with the family. It's Christmas Day and all.
Do you work here?
Oh, no. A regular guy needed the day off because his wife and kids were going to divorce him. So I said, I can open a beer, pour whiskey as good as anybody else's. Hey, what'll it be? It's on the house.
I don't remember ever needing a drink as much as I do right now. I'm not really a drinker.
I'm not a bartender. Come on, give me something to do back here.
I'll have a soda.
Rough day, huh?
Yeah. I think I'm losing my mind.
You're Trinity.
What? I'm a miracle?
Yeah. Yeah. That sounds like a bad pickup line. Truth is, I always liked you.
Really? Is that why you dated my sister?
Oh, yeah. It's back in high school. It's another lifetime. I know quality when I see it. Were you the one who liked the rain and never carried an umbrella? The one who drew the caricature of the principal on the cafeteria blackboard you thought no one was looking? And the Sarah that I'm thinking about, she cried over a Robert Frost poem in English, and then she beat up the girl who pointed it out to the rest of the class.
That sounds like something I would have done. I don't really do that anymore.
Good to know. And as I recall, she liked to dance, but she always said no when somebody asked her.
You never ask.
I'm asking now.
It's like a waltz. I begin to see the pattern. You know, Beth would have a problem, and I would just leap in to smooth it all out, to fix it, you know? Just like I came back here, all ready to do.
Don't beat yourself up on this. That's what parents do.
But it's an old dance, honey. And nothing ever really gets fixed, and Beth, she just feels lousy. So, maybe that's not why I'm here. Maybe I should be listening. Maybe that's what needed fixing. What do you think of that, dance partner?
I don't feel so good.
Beth! Beth, it's your father! Dad, he just slipped over.
Felt a little faint is all.
It's not his time yet. And of course you would know that, wouldn't you? Did you call the doctor?
I don't need a doctor.
He didn't want me to. And you listened to him? He wouldn't wear a coat in a blizzard unless you forced him to.
Listen to what I'm saying. I'm better now. I'm strong as a horse.
What do you need?
You've done too much for me already. All these years of putting up with me.
It's nothing to put up with, Pop.
My grease fires in the kitchen. My smoking. My piano playing.
Okay, yeah, the piano, I'm gonna give you that one.
I don't say this very much. In fact, I don't know if I ever say it. But If it hadn't been for you...
I know how you feel.
What are you doing?
Making some soup for Dad. It's soup. How hard can it be?
It's not as hard as you make it look. I think there's a bed tray around here somewhere.
You were gone for an hour and I couldn't take care of him. How have you done it alone all these years?
He's not so bad, really. He's no worse than a kid. Or a puppy.
But I just went off and left you to do everything.
Well, you had responsibilities. I understood that.
I don't know if I would have. I probably would have resented you for leaving me with all the work.
You're stronger than you think. You just never had to test it before. Until now.
You know, I didn't do for either one of my girls what I should have done. I loved one of them too much. And the other one, well, not nearly enough.
Now, hold on a minute. If anyone made a mistake, it was me. I didn't know how to be a father. I only knew how to be a husband. And when you left, girls need talking to, and I was never one for that. You needn't fret about Sarah. Sarah's good. Beth is a surprise.
Things haven't been as easy for Beth as you might think. Just ask her.
All this for soup. She doesn't cook much. Another thing I never taught her. What was I thinking? So, you want to talk about Joe?
I guess I have to accept the fact his family has no secrets anymore.
Yeah, you'll handle this same way you've handled everything else.
Can I be honest with you?
Well, if not now, when?
I always felt like a stranger in this house. The best thing that I did was never as good as the worst thing that Beth did. After a while, I just gave up trying.
You really saw it that way?
And drugs were an easy escape. And when I met Joe, I was just a mess. I knew that he wasn't the one, but he offered me some stability. And eventually I figured out I needed to turn my life around. But I spent years with someone I didn't love. Who didn't love me because it was familiar.
I had no idea you were hurting so much. I always, always loved you, Sarah.
Did you?
You didn't know that. It's one thing for me to feel it, but if you don't feel it... I loved you, darling. I always will. That's all I ever needed to hear. Oh.
Do you understand why I haven't visited more often?
Of course I do. You're a busy woman, important job and all.
I call every week.
Almost every week, yes.
But it isn't the same as being there, is it?
Honey, a child's job is to grow up and leave the nest and build a nest of her own. And you've done that fine.
I'm gonna have a baby.
A baby? You're... Sweetheart, this is the best news I've had in years.
It would be if it were 2 or 3 years from now. My whole next year is planned. I've got this conference in London next summer. This baby is going to change everything.
Change is what life is all about. And everything happens for a reason.
Even this child of yours? Grandpa, buddy.
Grandpa.
Hi, Joe.
Hey, your timing's perfect. You know, I found a little something in my glove box earlier. A little Christmas for the cab, huh?
Yeah, I put that in there, well, before. In case we weren't together for the holidays.
Well, she's great. And she's beautiful, thank you. But listen, Sarah. You know, look, I've been doing some thinking. And you know what? Maybe I was wrong. And anyway, I was just wondering if maybe we could...
No, you were right. That's, actually why I'm calling.
Because as much as we may both want this, I
don't think it's what either one of us needs.
You hear what I said? I'm trying to apologize.
Yeah, I know what you're doing. You've done it before.
You leave, you miss me, come back, and...
That's just not good enough this time. I just realized that I'm better than you think I am. I'm better than I think I am.
Where is this coming from?
You were there for me when I really needed you, and I will never...
Never forget that. But the fact is, this just...
It just isn't right for either of us.
Are you saying it's over?
I guess it is. Bye.
My beautiful, beautiful Sarah.
Winter, the days are short. Mm-hmm. Is that a problem? Mom,
we haven't had Christmas yet. Let's get your father and Beth, and let's go celebrate.
Come on. With what? Who's had time to buy gifts?
Don't worry, it's all taken care of. In it and my wishes for your life, and I was going to give it to you on the birth of your first child. Motherhood is such a precious gift, darling. I hope you find that in these pages.
Thank you.
Sarah?
That 20 years ago.
Oh, nothing's gone forever.
Open it up. It's a whole family. It's Grandma and Grandpa and everybody.
We're all in your corner, Sarah. Your life turned out perfectly, no matter how you arrived at it. It's just a reminder. How very much I love you.
I'll treasure this.
And Buddy.
Oh, I don't need anything. This Christmas with you was more than I could ever have asked for.
Just...
What is it, Pop?
It's all the memories of our life together.
There's so much to say still. You're wonderful. You're both everything you should be. I'm so proud of you.
Is it time?
No, not yet.
It's still Christmas. A carol. We need music. Just like we used to have. No, I can't.
Pop? He just wants to say goodbye.
Wait! Please! Lorraine! Wait! Lorraine! Please! Lorraine, it's too soon.
No matter how much time we have, it's never enough. But you have so much to do yet.
What do I have to live for?
For me. Enjoy all of this for both of us. The girls need you. And you're going to be a grandfather. You and I have all the time in the world to be together. Just not quite yet.
But without you...
You are never without me. Now do this. Go to the Christmas service tonight. Someone's expecting you.
Expecting me? Who?
I love you so much, buddy.
I love you too.
And that'll be ours forever.
Lorraine? Lorraine?
Sarah, I want you to be part of my baby's life.
It would mean a lot to me. And if you ever need anything, I'll be there for you.
Thank you. And if you need any help with that business of yours?
My refrigerator magnets?
Your folk art. You let me know. I have some experience in that area.
Might mean we'd have to talk more often. Maybe even visit occasionally.
Well, if we have to, we have to. Look at your hair in that picture.
That's not right.
Pop! You okay?
Yeah. I'm fine. I just needed a little time to say goodbye, that's all. But there's a church service tonight, and we need to go to it because I promised your mom we would. Okay?
Okay.
Too late to share in a little Christmas cheer?
What are you doing here?
Oh. You know we haven't been away from each other on a holiday yet. I didn't want this to be the first.
I love you.
I love you.
Hey, buddy.
David.
Sarah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Come on, I've got something I want to tell you.
Am I gonna like this?
You're gonna love this.
Sarah. I have to tell you, I'm not going back to the apartment.
No?
Person has to be where they fit. I belong here.
Me too.
Do you mean that? That's great. That's great. Together, we can make this right again.
Together. I like the sound of that, Pop. Spitting thing coming.
Mom made me stop.
Yeah. Moms know best. You're gonna learn that soon enough. See ya.
Night.
Hi.
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, suppose you'll be headed back to L.A.
soon. I don't know. Trinity's a nice little town. People are pleasant enough. I might be sticking around for a little while.
I heard that you had someone back in.
I did. We moved on.
How about another dance then?
I'd say that's not entirely out of the question.
That was a lovely service.
Merry Christmas.
Only one thing puzzles me. Your mother said someone was expecting me here tonight. And I don't think it was Reverend Pritchard.
What is this?
Recipe card. Unabridged.
How did it get there?
Nellie?
Oh.
Hi. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, buddy.
I have something. Lorraine wanted me to get you this.
Lorraine?
It's a long story, but there were some ingredients missing from that recipe.
And Lorraine?
Like I say, it's a long story.
Well, I'd like to hear it. Maybe you could come by for dinner sometime.
I'd like that. I'd like that fine.
Me too.
You have a happy holiday.
You too, buddy.
Merry Christmas, Daddy.
And a Happy New Year.
For the first time in a long while, I truly believe it will be. Let's go home.
It truly is amazing the things you miss when you're gone for good. It's always the little things, the things you took for granted. But the real miracle is that they happened at all. And you carry the memories of those times with you, beyond December, beyond Christmas, forever.